Hello students, today we shall be discussing the concept of radioactivity. As you all know, what do you mean by radioactivity? Radioactivity means that the heavy elements are capable of spontaneously emitting some particles. Those particles could be alpha particles, beta particles, gamma rays and many other elementary particles. So they disintegrate to form the stable product nucleus. So radioactivity was discovered accidentally by Henry Becquerel in 1896. What they found that they had placed some uranium wrapped in a paper, and the paper wrapped which was wrapped by uranium in it was kept near the photographic plates, and they saw that the uranium had affected the photographic plates. Means that uranium had some peculiar properties that were affecting the photographic plates. So this radioactivity was then carried out by Rutherford and his co-workers. They performed the experiment by placing the radioactive radium between the lead, and they saw that they had placed the radioactive radium between the electric plates of the electric field. They saw that the radium had some particles emitting through them. Some positive charge particles were seen attracted towards the negative plate of the electric field, and some particles of negatively charged had been attracted to the positive plates of the electric field, and some particles went undeflected. Similarly, Rutherford and his co-workers also applied this by keeping the uranium under magnetic field. There also they found that some particles had bent to the north pole of the magnetic field, some had bent to the south pole of the magnetic field, and some went undeflected. From this, they had come to the conclusion that there were three types of emission from the radioactive elements. Those were alpha emission, beta emission and gamma ray emission. So what was alpha emission, beta emission and gamma emission? In alpha emission, what happens? In alpha emission, the parent nucleus undergoes a disintegration in such a way that it forms a daughter nucleus having the atomic number reduced by 2 and the mass number reduced by 4, and it produces a helium particle 2He4. Similarly, in beta decay process, the parent nucleus undergoes disintegration to form the daughter nucleus, where the atomic number of the daughter nucleus is increased by 1 and the mass number remains the same, and they emit the fast moving electrons that are negatively charged. So the third particle that they found was the gamma rays, and the gamma rays are produced when the parent nucleus, which are in the excited state, comes down to the lower ground state and they emit the gamma rays, or they are the electromagnetic rays. So the gamma rays has an energy equal to the difference between the two levels, that is the transition energy levels. So let us now study the properties of the three particles: alpha particle, beta particle and gamma particle. So here there is a table that is also differentiating the properties of alpha, beta and gamma rays. So the composition of alpha particle is that the alpha particle consists of helium nucleus, that is 2He4. So in the helium nucleus, what will be there? The number of protons here will be equal. So the composition of alpha particle is that it consists of helium nucleus. Helium nucleus is 2He4. That means that the number of the atomic number is the number of protons. So here we have 2 protons. And 4 is the mass number, which is the sum of proton and neutrons. So if we subtract the number of protons, we get the number of neutrons. So we get 2 neutrons. So alpha particle is nothing but the helium nucleus consisting of 2 protons and 2 neutrons. And the beta particles are the fast moving electrons, which are negatively charged, whereas the alpha particle was positively charged. Where the gamma rays are neutral and they are simply the electromagnetic rays which do not have any charge and they do not have any rest mass. The second property is that of the three particles is for the deflection by electric field and magnetic field. Both the alpha particle and the beta particles are deflected by electric field and magnetic field, as was proved by the Rutherford experiment. Here it is shown that the alpha particle as well as the beta particle both are deflected to the opposite ends by keeping them in electric field and well in the magnetic field. So both alpha particle exhibit deflection, and they show their presence that the alpha particles are positively charged, and since beta particles also deflected by electric and magnetic field, so they also confirm that they are negatively charged particles. But the gamma rays are not deflected either by the electric field or by the magnetic field, and this shows that they are uncharged or neutral particles. The fourth point is of the fluorescence. The alpha particle and the beta particle shows fluorescence, means they are capable of producing scintillation on the fluorescent material of the screen. So if we keep a screen of barium platinocyanide, zinc sulfide or any other material, they show fluorescence, whereas the beta particle shows fluorescence in the zinc sulfide or any other fluorescent materials. If we compare the velocities of these particles, the velocity of the alpha particle has been found to vary from 1.5 into 10 to the power 7 meter per second to 2.2 into 10 raised to the power 7 meter per second. Whereas the beta particle is very fast moving electron, so it has a velocity 2.97 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and this is comparable to the velocity of light. So it is also been shown that the velocity of beta particles is 10 to 15 times more than the velocity of alpha particle, whereas the gamma rays always travel with the velocity of light. So now for the penetration power, the alpha particle, beta particles are capable of penetrating the materials. The penetration power of the alpha particle is low as compared to the beta particle. Since alpha particle is heavier than the beta particle, so its penetration power is low. So it has a low penetration power. The thin foils can absorb them, means it can penetrate the thin foil, but the depth of the thickness to which it is penetration is small, that is only 0.01 centimeter. So aluminium foil of thickness can absorb, which is having a thickness of 0.01 centimeter, and the air of thickness of 7 centimeter has the capacity to stop a fast moving alpha particle. So where if we compare for the beta particle has more penetration power, as its mass is also less as compared to the alpha particle, and its velocity is also high. So the beta particle penetrates more inside the material as compared to the alpha particle. But if we look at the gamma rays has the highest penetration power, where the penetration power of the gamma rays is 100 times more than the penetration power of beta rays. So what we can conclude that the beta has more penetration power as compared to alpha particle, where gamma rays has 100 times more penetration power than the beta particles. So the next property we can discuss about the ionizing power. What do you mean by ionize? Ionization means that when they pass, suppose if they're passing through air, so they would produce ion pair of the air molecules. So the alpha particle is a charged particle having two positive charges. So a single alpha particle can produce 20,000 ion pairs per centimeter of air. Means in 1 centimeter of air, it can ionize 20,000 particles. So what a high rate of ionizing power of alpha particle. Whereas since beta particle has only one negative charge and alpha particle was having two positive charge, so it would ionize more in comparison to beta particle. So that is why the ionizing power of the beta particle is 1/100th time. It is 100th time lesser ionizing power than that of the alpha particle. So the ionizing power of gamma rays is not there, and if we say that gamma rays is capable of, so then the ionizing power of gamma is also 1/100th time of the beta particle. So this concludes that the ionizing power of the alpha particle is 10,000 times more than the ionizing power of gamma rays and 100 times more than the ionizing power of the beta rays. So it has the highest ionizing power. So since they are again charged particles, so when they pass through thin metal foils, they get scattered. Similarly, the beta particles are also negatively charged, so they also get scattered, but to a lesser extent. They get scattered, but to a lesser extent as compared to alpha particles, and gamma rays are neutral particles, so they do not get scattered. So, as we have seen here also, that when the Henry Becquerel had placed the uranium wrapped in thick paper, it affected the photographic plates. So definitely the alpha particles and beta particles were produced by the uranium, so they were capable of affecting the photographic plates. So they affected the photographic plates, alpha particles, beta particles also affected, and gamma rays also affected the photographic plates. But what they found that the wavelength of the gamma rays is less as compared to the wavelength of the X-rays by 10 raised to power minus 11 meter to 10 raised to power minus 13 meter. Means the gamma rays has a smaller wavelength as compared to X-rays. So the decay process, again we shall discuss that the parent nucleus is disintegrating into the forming the stable daughter nucleus by emitting out 2He4, where the daughter nucleus is atomic number is reduced by 2 and the mass number is reduced by 4. Similarly, in beta particle where there is electron emission, so the daughter nucleus has its atomic number increased by 1, where the mass number remains the same. So this means that they are isobars here. And here in the gamma ray emission, the parent and the daughter nucleus are just differing in the energy states. One of them is in the higher energy state and the other is in the lower energy state, that whenever the daughter or parent is moving from higher to lower energy state, a gamma ray is produced. So these were the properties that we discussed for the alpha particle, beta particle and gamma rays, and that is why we say that the spontaneous emission of radiation by the element, by heavy elements more precisely, where the mass number is greater than 210, it has the property to spontaneously emit the particles such as alpha particle, beta particle and gamma rays. So such spontaneous emission by heavy element, this process is called radioactivity, and the elements which exhibit this process of radioactivity are said to be radioactive elements. And these process of radioactivity was very successfully determined by Marie Curie, Becquerel and Soddy, and even Marie Curie got a Nobel Prize for this. So I hope that you have understood the concept of radioactivity. Thank you.